How may I help?
Hello guys, I'm your presenter for today and we're going to talk about the bronchiectasis. So this is my table of contents or the presentation outline all pertaining to bronchiectasis. So what is bronchiectasis? It is a condition in which damage to the airways causes them to widen and become flabby and scarred. And for the second one, usually is the result of an infection or other condition that injures the walls of the airways or prevents the airways from clearing mucus. Mucus is a slimy substance that the airway produces to help remove inhaled dust, bacteria, and other particles. And in the third one, the airways slowly lose their ability to clear out mucus. And when mucus can't be cleared, it builds up and creates an environment in which bacteria can grow. This leads to repeated serious lung infections. And for the fourth one, each infection causes more damage to your airways. Over time, the airways lose their ability to move air in and out. And because of that, this can prevent enough oxygen from reaching your vital organs. For the next, it can lead to serious health problems such as respiratory failure, atelectasis, and heart failure. Atelectasis is a collapsed lung, so just in case if you don't know the term. For the overview, as you can see, there's a figure that shows a cross-section of the lungs with normal airways and with the widened airways. So, overview. Bronchiectasis can affect just one section of one of your lungs or many sections of both lungs. The initial lung damage that leads to bronchiectasis often begins in childhood. However, symptoms may not occur until months or even years after you start having repeated lung infections. Then, bronchiectasis usually is due to a medical condition that injures the airway walls or prevent the airways from clearing mucus. Examples of such conditions include cystic fibrosis and primary ciliary dyskinesia. Next, bronchiectasis that affects only one part of the lung may be caused by a blockage rather than a medical condition. Moving on, bronchiectasis can be congenital or acquired. Congenital bronchiectasis affects infants and children. And for the last, acquired bronchiectasis occurs as a result of another condition or factor. This type of bronchiectasis can affect adult and older children. So, what are the causes? Damage to the walls of the airway usually is the cause of bronchiectasis. A lung infection may cause this damage. Examples of lung infections that can lead to bronchiectasis include severe pneumonia, whooping cough or measles, tuberculosis, and fungal infections. On the next part, conditions that damage the airway and raise the risk of lung infections also can lead to bronchiectasis. Examples of such conditions include cystic fibrosis is a genetic condition that affects a protein in the body. People who have cystic fibrosis have a faulty protein that affects the body cells, tissues, and the glands that make mucus and sweat. Next, immunodeficiency disorders, such as common variable immunodeficiency and less often HIV and AIDS. Allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis. This is an allergic reaction to a fungus called Aspergillus, and it causes swelling in the airways. Disorders that affect cilia function, such as primary ciliary dyskinesia. Cilia are small, hair-like structures that line your airways. They help clear mucus out of your airways. Then we have chronic pulmonary aspiration. This is a condition in which you inhale food, liquids, saliva, or vomited stomach contents into your lungs. Aspiration can inflame the airways, which can lead to bronchiectasis. Then, connective tissue diseases, such as rheumatoid arthritis, Sjogren's syndrome, and Crohn's disease. Other conditions, such as airway blockage, also can lead to bronchiectasis. Many things can cause a blockage, such as a growth or a non-cancerous tumor. An inhaled object, such as a piece of a toy or a peanut that you inhaled as a child, also can cause an airway blockage. Then, a problem with how the lungs form in a fetus may cause congenital bronchiectasis. This condition affects infants and children. So, what are the preventions for bronchiectasis? To prevent bronchiectasis, it is important to prevent the lung infections and lung damage that can cause it. So, first, childhood vaccines for measles and whooping cough prevents infection related to this illness. These vaccines also reduce complications from these infections, such as bronchiectasis. Avoiding toxic fumes, gases, smoke, and other harmful substances also can help protect your lungs. Proper treatment of lung infections in children also may help preserve lung function and prevent lung damage that can lead to bronchiectasis. Stay alert to keep children and adults from inhaling small objects such as a piece of toys and food that might stick in a small airway. If you think your child or someone else has inhaled a small object, seek prompt medical care. In some cases, treating the underlying cause of bronchiectasis can slow or prevent its progression. Moving on to the signs and symptoms. The initial airway damage that leads to bronchiectasis often begins in childhood. However, signs and symptoms may not appear until months or even years after you start having repeated lung infections. The most common signs and symptoms of bronchiectasis are a daily cough that occurs over months or years, daily production of large amounts of sputum which you cough up and spit out, may contain mucus, a slimy substance, trapped particles, and pus, shortness of breath and wheezing, then chest pain and clubbing. When the flesh under your fingernails and toenails gets thicker, it's called clubbing. Now, to the complications of bronchiectasis. The complications are severe bronchiectasis can lead to other serious health conditions such as respiratory failure and atelectasis. Then, respiratory failure can cause shortness of breath, rapid breathing, and air hunger. It's a feeling like you can't breathe in enough air. Then, in severe cases, signs and symptoms may include a bluish color on your skin, lips, and fingernails, confusion, and sleepiness. Then, atelectasis is a condition in which one or more areas of your lungs collapse or don't inflate properly. As a result, you may feel shortness of breath, your heart rate and breathing rate may increase, and your skin and lips may turn blue. If bronchiectasis is so advanced that it affects all your parts of airways, it may cause heart failure. Then the last, the most common signs and symptoms of heart failure are shortness of breath or trouble breathing, tiredness and swelling in the ankles, feet, leg, abdomen, and veins in the neck. Moving on to the diagnosis. Your doctor may suspect bronchiectasis if you have a daily cough that produces large amounts of sputum. To find out whether you have bronchiectasis, your doctor may recommend tests such as identify any underlying causes that require treatment, rule out other causes of your symptoms, and find out how much your airways are damaged. And these are the diagnostic tests and procedures if you have bronchiectasis. So we have chest CT scan. This painless test creates precise pictures of your airways and other structures in your chest. A chest CT scan can show the extent and location of lung damage. And we have chest X-ray. This painless test creates pictures of the structures in your chest, such as your heart and lungs. A chest X-ray can show areas of abnormal lung and thickened irregular airways. And then bronchoscopy. If your bronchiectasis doesn't respond to treatment, your doctor may recommend bronchoscopy. Physicians use this procedure to look inside the airways, and in bronchoscopy can show whether you have a blockage in your airways. And now we have the medical management for bronchiectasis. Bronchiectasis often is treated with medicines, hydration, and chest physical therapy. Your doctor may recommend surgery if the bronchiectasis is isolated to a section of lung or you have a lot of bleeding. If the bronchiectasis is widespread and causing respiratory failure, your doctor may recommend oxygen therapy. So what are the goals of the treatment? The goals are to treat any underlying conditions and lung infections, remove mucus from your lungs, and maintain good hydration helps with mucus removal, and the last, prevent complications. And before I end my discussion, here are my references on this topic. Thank you for listening, and hope you learned something today. Stay safe and healthy, everyone.